Psalm chapter 146. Put not your trust in princes. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God while I have my being. Put not your trust in princes, in a son of man, in whom there is no salvation. When his breath departs, he returns to the earth. On that very day, his plans perish. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, who keeps faith forever, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the sojourners. He upholds the widow and the fatherless. But the way of the wicked he brings to ruin. The Lord will reign forever, your God, O Zion, to all generations. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are gathered to worship and confess our beliefs. We believe that the Bible, as originally written, was God-breathed, both verbally and in every part. It is the final authority of our faith and lifestyle. We believe in one God, the creator of heaven and earth, that in the unity of the Godhead, there are three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ, God's Son, was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of a virgin. He lived a sinless life, died and rose from the dead, ascended bodily to heaven, and is coming again to rapture his saints and establish his kingdom. We believe that the Holy Spirit is a divine person, equal with the Father and the Son and of the same nature. We believe man was created by the direct act of God and not from a previously existing form of life. By voluntary transgression, he fell from his state of innocence. Consequently, all men are now sinners by nature and by choice. We believe salvation of sinners is divinely initiated, wholly of grace, and accomplished only through the mediatorial work of the Son of God. It is not of works or religion. We believe in the local church and the universal church, which is the body of Jesus Christ. We believe water baptism is the single immersion of a believer in water, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to show his identification with Christ in his death, burial, and resurrection. It can do nothing for his salvation. We believe that the Lord's Supper is the commemoration of his death until he comes. We believe in the bodily resurrection of the just and the unjust. Believers by faith in Christ will spend eternity in the presence of God, unbelievers in everlasting punishment. We believe that every believer should live for God and separated from the world, and by the aid of the Holy Spirit should walk in Christian love and holiness. We believe that Jesus Christ commands his church to make disciples of every nation. We believe that the greatest thing man can do for himself is to love God above all, and the greatest thing he can do for others is to show them how to love God above all.
Have you been? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? May aga mga kauturan. May isa ka very popular nga song nga sang high school kami upon early college nga nagahambal or ang iyang lyrics nagasiling learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all. And kadamo sang mga mabatian man kita nga dapat unahon mo gid ang imo kaugalingon. Dapat ikaw naman, which partly guro may true kapipakon daw biktima ikaw sang inostisya. Pero kung lang tawon naton diri sa Bible nga isa sa mga butang nga ginawarn ni Apostle Paul sa kay Timothy nga amuna sa ulihi nga mga inadlaw, people will be lovers of themselves rather than lovers of God. They will do what seems good or what seems right in their own eyes rather than what God is telling them. Sa akon nga na-notice lang ha, hindi man ko ka-generalize, but most people I know nga ang ila lang lagi na pinsar ang ila kaugalingon. Amo ini ang mga tawo nga tam-an gid ka lonely, no? Kasubo sang kabuhi. Ukon dissatisfied sila sa kabuhi or both lonely and dissatisfied. And as I have encouraged you always, the best way to live is to live for God and to live for others. So sa sini nga aga magatuon naman kita parte sa kabuhi sa isa ka tawo nga because he lived for God and he lived for others for sure very 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 satisfied siya subong no hindi lang sang I mean hindi lang sang una but subong nga ara siya sa langit. So please open your Bibles, padayuno naton ang aton pagtuon sa Book of Ruth. Kagbasahon naton ang Ruth chapter 4. Kag mag-start kita diri sa verse 1. Ang pulong sa Ginoo nagasiling, "Now Boaz had gone up to the gate and sat down there. And behold, the Redeemer of whom Boaz had spoken came by. So Boaz said, 'Turn aside, friend, sit down here.' And he turned aside and sat down. And he took 10 men from the elders of the city and said, 'Sit down here.' So they sat down. And when he said to the Redeemer, 'Naomi, who has come back from the country of Moab, is selling the parcel of land that belonged to our relative Elimelech. So I thought I would tell you of it and say, buy it in the presence of those sitting here and in the presence of the elders of my people. If you will redeem it, redeem it. But if you will not, tell me that I may know, for there is no one besides you to redeem it, and I come after you.' And he said, 'I will redeem it.' Then Boaz said, 'The day you buy the field from the hand of Naomi, you also acquire Ruth the Moabite, the widow of the dead, in order to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance.' Then the Redeemer said, 'I cannot redeem it for myself, lest I impair my own inheritance. Take my right of redemption yourself, for I cannot redeem it.' Now this was the custom in former times in Israel concerning redeeming and exchanging. To confirm a transaction, the one drew off his sandal and gave it to the other. And this was the manner of attesting in Israel. So when the Redeemer said to Boaz, 'Buy it for yourself,' he drew off his sandal. Then Boaz said to the elders and all the people, 'You are witnesses this day that I have bought from the hand of Naomi all that belonged to Elimelech and all that belonged to Chilion and to Mahlon. And Ruth the Moabite, the widow of Mahlon, I have bought to be my wife to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance, that the name of the dead may not be cut off from among his brothers, from the gate of his native place. You are witnesses this day. Then all the people who were at the gate and the elders said, we are witnesses. May the Lord make the woman who is coming into your house like Rachel and Leah, who together built up the house of Israel. And may he act worthily in Ephratah to be renowned in Bethlehem. And may your house be like the house of Perez, whom Tamar bore to Judah, because of the offspring of the Lord will give you by this young woman. So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife, and he went into her, and the Lord gave her conception, and she bore a son. Then the women said to Naomi, blessed be the Lord, who has not left you this day without a redeemer, and may his name be renowned in Israel. He shall be to you a restorer of life and a nourisher of your old age. For your daughter-in-law who loves you, who is more to you than seven sons, has given birth to him. Then Naomi took the child and laid him on her lap and became his nurse. And the women of the neighborhood gave him a name, saying, a son has been born to Naomi. And they named him Obed. He was the father of Jesse and the father of David. Now, these are the generations of Perez. Perez fathered Hezron. And Hezron fathered Ram. Ram fathered Aminadab. Aminadab fathered Nashon. Nashon fathered Salmon. Salmon fathered Boaz. And Boaz fathered Obed. And Obed fathered Jesse. And Jesse fathered David. Mag-pray kita, Anay. Father God, salamat sa sininga-agang, makasimba kami sa imo, sa Espiritu kagamatuuran. Gabeg gid kaming, ikaw gid, mag-cleanse sa amon from all unrighteousness. Nagabeg kaming ang Holy Spirit, magapakig-ambal paagi sa imo alagad. Ang Holy Spirit, magapanghikot gid sa amon, agod nga, maintindihan gid namon ang imo pulong. Kabay paamay nga tagaan mo gid kami sa concentration, na ang makapungko kami, kagmakapamati, kag later on, Father, tuduin man kami kung paano ininamon ma-apply sa among kabuhi. Kay ginasugo mo kami nga hindi lang kami dapat manugpabati sa imo pulong, kundi mga manugbuhat sini. So Lord, please be with us. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Nagatuon kita sa Book of Ruth kag natun-an naton una nga even though nag-struggle kita sa aton kabuhi, ang spreading wings of God, no, are protecting us. That even though nga nagasiling ikaw nga, ano ni man, dead end na ini, wala na ini palaabuton, no? wala na ni magagandang bukas. But we said, just like in the case of Naomi, ang Ginoo, no? Ang Ginoo, as he spread his wings over them during that time, ang iya provision, ang iya nga working has just begun. We also learned nga hindi lang nga magpaidalom kita under the spreading wings of God, but we need also to spread our wings to others. Just like sa kay Naomi, we need to sow love wherever we are. Because ang aton pag-sow sang love, pag-touch sa ila, will be a way for them to find God. Kag it's possible, kung ara man kita sa mga difficulties sa aton nga kabuhi, just like sa natabo kay Ruth, may mga tao nga willing mag-upod sa imo, may mga tao nga willing mag-unong sa imo. Last time, nagtuon man kita nga ang pag-spread sang wings naton, kinahanglan man nga i-level up. Just like sa kay Ruth. Si Ruth did not only sympathize sa kay Naomi, no, pero nag-unong gid siya. She went with her despite of the uncertainties. Amuna gani naghambal kita last time, it's good to do random acts of love, random acts of kindness, but it is better to be intentional in spending time, in journeying with someone in life. Pero sa siningation, no, medyo ma highest level kita, no, the intensity 3 na ini, no. Because sometimes God is calling us, no, to spread our wings, even it would cost us a lot. It would cost us a fortune. It would cost our name. And humanly speaking, despite of those investment, wala kita sang ginatulok nga earthly return. Kag amuna, no? Kabudlay. Kabudlay ng magpalangga nga wala ikaw sang ginapaabot nga balik. Kabudlay magbuya sang resources kun nga daw hindi ka man siguro nga may ginansya. Pero kabalo kita nga amo ini ang ginpakita ni Boaz diri sa Book of Ruth. If you remember, sa Ruth chapter 3 verse 9, after nga ginsugo ni Naomi nga kadtuan ni Ruth si Boaz, no, kag i challenge niya or encourage niya si Boaz to be the redeemer, no, to do his part, so si Ruth naglakat didto. Kag nakibot si Boaz sa pagbugtaw niya tungang gabi, nga may babayi nga ara sa tupad niya. Selling sang Bible, there is a Ruth chapter 3 verse 9, and he said, "Who are you?" And she said, "I am Ruth, your servant." And then she said, "Spread your wings over your servant, for you are a redeemer." Ikaw ang amon kinsman redeemer. Now, ano ini ang kinsman redeemer? Ang kinsman redeemer, kuno amo ining someone who redeemed what was lost, no? Nabawi, na? Nagbawi sa isa kabutang nga nadula. He is a rescuer or a restorer. Now, this was not a passive obligation o kon something ang isa ka person magsulod siya kag hindi niya pagseryosohon. Being a kinsman redeemer, may tatlo siya ka may tatlo ka obligations. Una, ang kinsman redeemer ka, you are there to rescue the land owned by a family member that was in danger of being lost to someone else, or to rescue the family member himself from being sold into bond servitude. So kung ikaw pariente, no, kag nakita mo ang isa mo ka pariente nga daw mabankrupt na, no, kag ang ila propiedad balawion na or kuluwaon na, you as a kinsman redeemer, as pariente, no, pwede mo na nga kadtuan kag ikaw ang magbayad sang utang, no, para mabalik sa imong pariente. O kon base may utang siya nga dako, wala sa sang property, tihimuon siya sang slave, pwede mo na magawad. Siling sang Leviticus chapter 25 verse 25, ang pulong sang Ginoo nagasiling, "If your brother becomes poor and sells part of his property, then his nearest redeemer shall come and redeem what his brother has sold." Kun aton diri lantawon, no, according sa mga nagatuon sa kultura sang mga Hudiyo during that time, ang kinsman redeemer, kuno, didn't get to keep the land he had redeemed. Once mabayad nila, mabayaran nila, hindi na iyang sa ila na magkadto. No? Or if he had rescued a relative from bond servitude, the rescued family member didn't have didn't then become the kinsman redeemer's slave. It does not mean nga ti kung inog esklabuho na to siya, kaginbayran mo, hindi na pwede nga imo pariente, imuon mo siya nga esklabo. No? Because gin-redeem mo siya, kagin-restore mo siya sa iyang nga daan nga sitwasyon. However, kuno, out of pure gratitude, no, atong gin-rescued relative, no, could offer to stay under the authority of the kinsman redeemer who paid for his freedom. So, sa paggawad, paghambal ni Ruth kay Boaz, gawaron mong amon nga kwa? Nga duta. Paghuon ni Boaz, gawaron niya na. Pero ang duta, makadto sa kanday, Ruth. Number two, the nearest unmarried male relative is to marry the widow and to provide her with an ear and redeem her land. Ang kinsman redeemer ko, no, kun may na widow, no, nga pariente, pwede na niya makuha, no, para nga ang ining widow, no, may ear to redeem her land. Amo na ginhambal sa Deuteronomy chapter 25 verse 5. If brothers dwell together and one of them dies and has no son, the wife of the dead man shall not be married outside the family to a stranger. Her husband's brother shall go into her and take her as his wife and perform the duty of a husband's brother to her. Siling sang verse 6, and the first son whom she bears shall succeed to the name of his dead brother, that his name may not be blotted out of Israel. So amoy ini ang practice nila, kag according sa isa ka author, siling niya ini ginhimo because the widow is to be protected from social and economic marginalization or abuse. Kay kun widow ka dito sang una, ti wala kaya means nga magpangita sang mga kinanglanon mo sa adlaw-adlaw nga tanan, kay ti ang work is usually available sa mga lalaki. Kung nakita ninyo dito si Ruth, ang pag-abot niya, ang work lang gid nga available sa iya amo to. Ang mamudyot, no, ang mamudyot sang salin, no, sa nagakaladagdag nga mga barley nga gina harvest during that time. Kadua, the covenant land or land inheritance or estate of the dead man is protected and the family has a livelihood, no. So kung pangasawon ng amo na, no, maka may ang property mas well protected kung may lalaki, no, kung may lalaki nga naga-handle sini. Pero importante pagid amo ang number three, the child born to the widow, which amo ato ginbasa nato sa verse, will be considered the son of the dead man. Hindi iya sang kinsman redeemer, not the genetic father, thus preserving his name. Ang ikatatlo nga responsibility man sa kinsman redeemer, amo niyang avenger. No, hindi ang Avenger nga movie, nga daw mga superhero sila. Kundi, kung may pariente ka nga ginpatay, you are obliged, no, to put justice, no, sa imong kamot. Amo na gani nga dira sa Old Testament, sa Book of Joshua, kag I think sa Deuteronomy, may mga 40 ka ng Levite cities nga gintawag nga cities of refuge. No, agod nga, ang isa ka person, kung may napatay siya, nga hindi siya hungod, makadalagan siya dito, kag makaseek refuge, nga because, assume ina, nga may mga kinsman redeemer, nga who will seek justice and seek retribution sa ginhimo sa sining tawo nga nakapatay against sa iyang pariente. So kung lang tawon ni Moderi, si Ruth was asking Boaz, hindi na tong Avenger. No, kay wala man diri sang pariente sila nga ginpatay. Kundi si Ruth was paghambal niya, spread your wings over your servant because you are our redeemer. Ang ginhambal ni Ruth is that nang Boaz perform your responsibility as our redeemer. Two responsibilities. You know, si Boaz, pwede gid siya kasiling bawday, nanuman. Ginayuhan ta na kagani, ha? Ginpaboranta na ka. Kung nakita mo, ang imo yung dala permi sa balay ninyo, daan mo, kumpara sa iban, no? Nung ginayuhan ta na ka. Do ka sobra naman niya sa imong nga ginapangayo. Pero siling diri sa Ruth chapter 3 chapter 4 verse 10 sing sampulong sang Ginoo. Chapter 3 verse 10, sorry. May you be blessed by the Lord, my daughter. You have made this last kindness greater than the first in that you have not gone after young men, whether poor or rich. Gindayaw ni Boaz si Ruth because instead nga Moab's way, do pero gusto bala kadumdum ka mo to sa ginhambal ni nanay niya Naomi, puli ka mo, kagpangita ka mo sa inyo bana. No? Kag pwede gid ina mahimo nga style ni Ruth. But instead, nagsubmit siya sa culture sa mga Israelites nga he wanted to provide no solutions sa sitwasyon nila ni nanay niya Naomi God's way. Ambot mo man kita sina. No. Ti why mo kaya gasiling himuon ta ini, no? Mahulat ka sang balo ano gani sa kiti hindi man iniya practice naton no kag ini siya nga practice gintudlo ni sa during the time sang mga Israelites. But the point here is sa aton kabuhi no, especially sa aton nga love life or ano man kasi sang life, are we doing it God's ways? Gaulo yung binto kaya sang imo mga pamaagi, the way nga kung ano lang ang maayo sa imo mata. Siling ni Boaz, siling niya verse 11, now my daughter, do not fear, I will do for you all that you asked, for all my fellow townsmen know that you are a worthy woman. Kinami man bala sang encouragement ni Boaz niya, ya bagay ka gid man. Bagay gid man ka mo. Verse 12, and now it is true that I am the Redeemer. Proceed niya, yet there is a Redeemer nearer than I, may mas lapit pa ka mo nga pariente. Remain tonight, and in the morning, if he will redeem you, good, let him do it. But if not willing to redeem you, then, as the Lord lives, I will redeem you. Lie down until morning. This is chapter 4, verse 1. True to his word. Even though nga si Boaz, kumbaga, daw dihado, gindiri siya sa partida. Number one, ang iyang manggad maibanan kay tiibaya dito sa duta ni Elimelech. Number two, pakasawon niya si Ruth, Pero this will be a continuation sa name ni Elimelech, hindi man iya. And yet, there is a Ruth, sa verse 1, sang Ruth chapter 4, Boaz had gone up to the gate and sat down there. Ano ini ang city gate? Ang city gate, kumbaga, doon mo ni siya ga-function nga daw ila city hall. No, where transactions, where agreements, no, are being conducted. Ti nakita ya man to ang kwan, no, nakita ya to ang pariente, no, atong closer nga kinsman redeemer kagintawag niya, no, silingya. And behold, the redeemer of whom Boaz had spoken came by. So Boaz said, "Turn aside, friend, sit down here." And he turned aside and sat down. Abay, kabalo nga, agtawag niya friend. Nang dapat gitawag niya di kasa, primo, o kon tito. Wala ta kabalo kon ang relasyon. But for sure, bangod kay somewhat sila ang pinaka-close na relative ni Boaz, it could mean nga ng parintihan, close relative man sila. Nga tipungko ka di. Kapag katapos, nagtawag man siya 10 men. You know, he took 10 men of the elders of the city and said, "Sit down here." So they sat down. Daw, grabe bala no, nga daw ka, I mean, sa sininga sitwasyon, makita natin nga si Boaz, no, is a man being looked up sa community, kay daw kapos lang sa iya mag-ariglat. No? Pagtawag niya sa atong closer relative, pungko mo lang dayon. Sa nagtawag siya sa mga elders, nagpungko mo lang dayon. Tinagsiling siya sa Redeemer, verse 3, "Then he said to the Redeemer, Naomi, who has come back from the country of Moab, is selling the parcel of land that belonged to our relative Elimelech. So I thought I would tell you of it and say, buy it in the presence of those sitting here and in the presence of the elders of my people." Niya baklabi. No? Sili niya kay ti, parintita ni. If you will redeem it, redeem it. Pero kung hindi ka, but if you will not, tell me that I may know. For there is no one besides you to redeem it, and I come after you. Okay, siling niya, sige. I will redeem it. So, atong pariente, willing siya mag-perform sa duty number one. Sige, buligan ta. Katuwa, siya ni Boaz, oh, by the way, may isa pagid gali. "The day you buy the field from the hand of Naomi, you also acquire Ruth the Moabite, the widow of the dead, in order to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance." Kahit kung bawion ng tong property, ibalik, hindi pwede, kahit wala sang lalaki sa pamilya. Siya niya, dapat pangasawahon mo man si Ruth, no, para nga ma-perpetuate ang ngalan. You know, kanami bala sininga kwan nga ruling sa among sa mga sa nga gin impress ang Ginoo sa mga taga Israel, because this is a way wala sang pamilya nga madulaan sang ila kaugalingon nga duta. Kahit isang una to ya, might is right. O kung shrewd kaya negosyante, te, kuha mo gidyatanan eh. Pero sa Ginoo, hindi. Dapat ma-regulate gid, nga bisan na bakal mo na, pwede ina mabawi. No? Pwede ina mabawi. So that ang tanan may duta. Te, pagkabati sang redeemer, siling niya, I cannot redeem it for myself. lest I impair my own inheritance. Na hindi, si Jerica ha? Yeah. Masawa pa gid. Yan, di lang kuha. Basi, mabululyaso ang akon nga inheritance. Yan, sige ha. Take my right of redemption yourself, for I cannot redeem it. Now, ano mga requirements? No, makatukitan na. Ano mga requirements para ikaw maging kinsman redeemer? Una sa tanan, dapat parinti kagid. No? Hindi pwede nga halin ikaw sa ibang nga tribo. Dapat dira ka. No? Parinti gid. Again, para ma-preserve ang property sa inyong nga tribo. Number two, amo ini, you had to be able to redeem. Dapat may kapasidad ikaw nga magbakal. Hindi man pwede nga. O sige, ako mabakal. Tidi ng kwarta mo, may ubra ka. Ay, sorry, wala. Hindi pwede. Ikatatlo, kung mag-redeem ka gid man, dapat bayaran mo gid sang full price. Hindi pwede nga partial lang. You have to pay the full cost of what you have redeemed. Ay kaapat, importante amo ini, you had to be willing. No? Hindi pwede nga napilitan ka lang. No? Hindi pwede nga ginpwersa ka lang. It has to come from a sincere heart. So, ato ang pariente ni Boaz, kag pariente kada Elimelech, able to redeem siya, probably may money siya to pay for the whole amount, may capacity siya, kag may money siya, ang problema lang gid galing, he was not willing. Nga nagbaylong iya nga pinsan. It's possible, according sa pila ka nag-comment diri, nag-comment sa sininga passage, nga in the first place, nang mabayad na siya, no, sa property, no, para nga ma-restore kanday now kanday Naomi kag Ruth, pagkatapos ang budlay kay si Ruth, kinahanglan pabataon pa niya kag provide niya pagid ini, no, kag later on kung magdamo pagid ang bata nila, bauti dako na gid nga sakit sang ulo. So some commentators even insinuated o kon na raise this possibility nga base ining kinsman redeemer may pamilya na siya nga iya. So kon mag-add pagid siya sa kay Ruth, that might cause a lot of strife within his family, and of course, you know, ang inheritance maglinapta pagid. That is why siling niya ayaw ko ng it's complicated life. So sila niya, Boaz, ikaw na lang. Ikaw na lang. It is a verse 7. Now, this was the custom in former times in Israel concerning redeeming and exchanging. So to confirm a transaction, one drew off his sandal and gave it to the other, and this was the manner of attesting in Israel. Base sa uli, isang una, ang mga chinelas, siya ay custom made, no? Siya ay, amun aguro ang agi, darati amun ang pamatuod, ari sa ako ng imo sandal, no? That means, nag-agree ikaw. So when the Redeemer said to Boaz, verse 8, buy it for yourself, paira yun iyang sandal. Deal? Siling ni Boaz, verse 9, then Boaz said to the elders and all the people, you are witnesses this day that I have bought from the hand of Naomi all that belong to Elimelech and all that belong to Chilion and to Malon. Also Ruth the Moabite, the widow of Malon, I have bought to be my wife, to perpetuate the name of the dead in his inheritance, that the name of the dead may not be cut off from among his brothers and from the gate of his native place. You are witnesses this day. Kaya namin, balaki after sa tudo ka, gulpi lang, daw nagsanag. Daw nagsanag ang scenario. Daw nag-sunshine siya layon in contrast sa negative nga kagloomy nga scenario sa chapter 1. Ganun daw ka ba sa to? Sang daw puro lang to injustisya, puro lang problema, puro lang tragedy ang nakalatabo sa kabuhi ni Naomi. But after nga ginbakal, gin-redeem ni Boaz, daw nagsanag. Then all the people who were at the gate and the elders said, "We are witnesses. May the Lord make the woman who is coming into your house like Rachel and Leah, who together built up the house of Israel." No? Siya tani, mangin parios ikaw kay Leah kag kay Rachel. No nga bangod sa ilang mga kabataan, amuna nakaangkon sila sa isa ka nasyon. No, may you act worthily in Ephrata and be renowned in Bethlehem. You know, hindi bala para ini sa ngalan ni Elimelech? Hindi bala para ini sa ngalan ni Mahlon? But it seems ang natabo diri nga gindayaw si Boaz, no? May the Lord make the woman who is coming into your house, no? May you act worthily in Ephrata and be renowned in Bethlehem, no? Magbantog ikaw. May your house be like the house of Perez, whom Tamar bore to Judah. Kung si Leah kag si Rachel ang ginggamit, no, in order nga makaangkon sa bilog nga nasyon nga Israel, si Judah kag si Tamar, no, si Tamar amo ang ginggamit sang Ginoo para nga makaangkon sang tribe of Judah. Kaya mo niya siling niya, whom Tamar bore to Judah because of the offspring that the Lord will give you by this young woman. So Boaz took Ruth, she became his wife, and he went into her, and the Lord gave her conception, and she bore a son. Kadami dari pala nga gin-emphasize nga ang Ginoo, amoy ang nagpabusong kay Ruth. Then the women said to Naomi, "Blessed be the Lord who has not left you this day without a redeemer. And may his name be renowned in Israel." Kaya may mga bladeri, no, nga sa ginubra ni Boaz, no, nadayaw ang Ginoo on how the Lord would provide a redeemer. No. Hindi to kanami man bala nga nakita sa mga babae dito nga ang bida at the end of the day, it was not Ruth, it was not Boaz. Ang bida sa gihapon amo ang Ginoo. No? He should be to you a restorer of life, a nourisher of your old age, for your daughter-in-law who loves you, who is more to you than 7 sons, has given birth to him. So Naomi took the child and laid him on her lap and became his nurse. And the woman of the neighborhood gave him a name. Wow, grabe man, no? Nga hindi si Boaz nagpangalan, maybe guro ginrespeto, yeah, because this alin sa name ni sang dapat sang pamilya ni Elimelech, no? Pero ang natabo, ang mga tupad balay ang naghatag ngalan. Bo grabe, mga kumare maniman, no? Ngingalanan nila Obed. Kag si Obed kuno amuning tatay ni Jesse, the father of David. Now, these are the generations of Perez. But siringon, si Perez amuni ang bata ni Judah. Si Perez fathered Hezron, and Hezron fathered Ram. Ram fathered Abinadab, and Abinadab fathered Nashon. Nashon fathered Salmon. Salmon fathered Boaz, and Boaz fathered Obed. Obed fathered Jesse, and Jesse fathered David. Sulit-sulit gid, kaduwag gid, asa kay David. In order, maybe, in order to emphasize how the Lord was pleased with the life, with the action of Boaz. Ngang iya nga desisyon, bisan daw dihado pa siya. Kasimple sang kabuhi iya, inkomplikar niya, and yet it produced the greatest king of Israel. Nang pamangkot nila, nga si Boaz, hindi man siya aloof sa mga foreigners. Ibala ka dumdum ka mo. Dumdum ka mo sa New Testament ang mga Israelites, no, ang mga Jews, no, makakita sila gani, Gentile, pananaw nila, unclean. Nga hindi kaya si Boaz. Ha? Kaya kung lang tawin nato sa Matthew chapter 1, starting verse 3, and Joaz, Judah, the father of Perez, and Sarah by Tamar, and Perez, the father of Hezron, and Hezron, the father of Ram, Ram, the father of Aminadab, no, daw muning parallel kay ina sa ginbasa naton sa last ng mga verses sang Ruth chapter 4, ugaling kay may mga ngalan lang diri sa mga babayi, and Aminadab, the father of Nashon, the father of Salmon, and Salmon, the father of Boaz, by Rahab, and Boaz, the father of Obed, by Ruth, and Obed, the father of Jesse. And of course, si Jesse, amo ang father ni David, nga amo ang hari. Now, kung na-notice din mo, si Rahab, based on Matthew chapter 1, verse 5, is the mother of Boaz. Kag kilala nyo ini si Rahab. Si Rahab, hindi ni siya Israelite. Canaanite ni siya. Kaya ang subok pagigani sa kay Rahab, kay prostitute ni siya. Sa nagpadala si Joshua sang spies dito sa Jericho, kung di nagatiner ini si Rahab. Ang duha ka spies nagkato sila dito sa sining place ang mga sa prostitute, nagkato sila kay Rahab. Pero dito nila na diskubrihan ngaya si Rahab maybe a prostitute. Pero amo ini because sang fame sang Ginoo, because sa ginapanghimo sang Ginoo sa Israel, si Rahab became a believer sang aton nga Ginoo, sang Diyos sa mga Israel. And that is why si Rahab lang gid kang iyang family ang naluwas when the Israelites attacked and the Lord destroyed the city of Jericho. Ambot kun buhi pa ni si Rahab sang gipakilala ni Boaz, pagpakilala ni Boaz si Ruth. Kasi siya, nay, mag-asawa na ko. Ngayon, mag-asawa, niya si Ruth. Ano siya? Byuda? Taga, ano nga tribo? Moabite. Gin-redeem ko. Taga-patigid ko nga si Rahab, all embrace, ano nga, nang gin-embrace siya siguro si Ruth as a picture ng Ginoo, hindi lang Ginoo sa mga Israelites, but it's also God of everyone who would come to Him. You know what, mga utod? Ang isang lakarason nga wala nagkita nag-care sa iban ng mga tao pag nga panumdom lang ginator aton kaugalingon. Wala kita gana magpakigbahin sa hilikuton sa Ginoo. Wala kita gana mag-share sa gospel. Huh? wala kita muta daw ginapasagdan na lang naton aton ko galingon kablok ako nga because nalipat ka mo nga para nga makakilala ikaw kay Jesus. May mga tao nga nagsuffer, may mga tao who went an extra mile, may mga tao nga nagpulaw, may mga tao nga naghilibion bangod sa mga unfairness nga ila na experience sa ila kabuhi para lang ang gospel makakadto sa imo. Gani mautod. Gusto na. Bangon ta. Bangon ta. Diri sa Bible may mga persons man nga diri sa Bible actually wala pa gid natapos ang blessing bangod sa ginhimo ni Boaz. Sa isang Bible dira sa Matthew chapter 1 verse 1. Diri na lang kay wala na kita time. Siya the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Though during that time paraya kay Boaz ya pagpangasawa ya kay Mary kay Ruth, no, was to perpetuate the name of Elimelech. Pero you know what? God thought it best to honor Boaz as the ancestor of David. Kag sino pagit? And the Lord Jesus Christ. Because Boaz did not only do it para sa tawo, but Boaz did this in obedience to God. And that is why, mga utod, you know, kung kaisa bala, hindi kita mag-iho kay, bala mo, ati, ano dara akon? Boaz, amot, kung napinsar yaman na to. But because of his love, because of his obedience sa sugo sa Ginoo, the Lord honored him. Dira man sa Bible daw, may mga tao dira nga gin point out man sa Ginoo because nag-level up man sila sa ilang gugma. Dumdum ka mo kay Hosea. Nagpangasawa siya sa prostitute. O kung nagsiling man sila halik sa house prostitute. Tapos nagbalik. Ha? Nagbalik sa daan nga batasan. Kagin auction na siya. Insugo siya sa Ginoo, balikitong asawa mo, baklaliwat, i-redeem. Si anong ginobra sa ni Hosea? Amo man, naglakat man siya. Kagin buy back niya. And Hosea became a beautiful, ang iyang story became a beautiful picture kung paano ang Ginoo magpalangga sa mga tao niya bisan unfaithful sila. Kadumduman kita sa ang story sa Good Samaritan, no? He's a Samaritan. Gina look down sa community but because level up ang iya nga pagigugma. Sa story, no, nangin he was honored by the Lord as a neighbor, no? As a man who truly loves his neighbor, an example of loving your neighbor as yourself. Pero kung may pinaka greatest reward dire, no, hindi lang nga si Boaz ancestor ni Jesus Christ, kay tikadamo man sang lain batasan nga nangin ancestor si Jesus Christ, ancestor ni Jesus Christ, hindi bala, no, pati yung mga kaday Manasseh, hindi bala, mga lain man to sila batasan. Pero kung may para sa akong pila ka dako nga daog nga win si Boaz because gin level up niya, no, ang iya pag-spread sang wings to others. Amo ini ang iya pagka kinsman redeemer became a picture of Jesus Christ as our kinsman redeemer. Kung kadumdum ka mo dito ang requirements sa isa ka kinsman redeemer dapat parihos sa aton. Muna si Jesus Christ, He became like us, no? He became flesh, siling sa John chapter 1. Number 2, si Jesus dapat able to redeem. Kagti, kabaluman kita, no? Nga nagkadto di siya, siling sang why ko na masulat sa aton nga PowerPoint, but sa Romans chapter 5, verse 19, as through the disobedience of one man, the many were made sinners, so also through the obedience of one man, the many will be made righteous. Kasi Jesus also paid a complete price. Nga dito sa cross, naghambal siya, it is finished. Ang isa pagid, no, kag-importante sa tanan, Jesus Christ willingly did it. Several times, nga daw pwede siya tani kaisol, pero siya hindi. I have to do the will of my Father. Like Boaz, nantawab lang, ginihambal sang Philippians chapter 2, siling ni Paul, encouraging the people sa Philippi, do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves. Muna, nga wala kita gana mag-intra sa kausa sa Ginoo, because we thought we are our lives, our hobbies, our entertainment, our fame, our lagaw-lagaw is more important than, significant than others. Persing ni Paul, dapat hindi amoy na. Nga, let each of you look not only to your own interests, but also to the interest of others. Have this mind among you, yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of man, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even the death on the cross. You know, to the highest level, bisan wala siya kwaod sa aton, Jesus Christ did it in order to save you and me. So anong expectations ang Ginoo sa aton? Silingya, this is my commandment, John chapter 15, starting verse 12. This is my commandment that you love one another as I have loved you. Grabe, no? Kung paano ako nangin kinsman redeemer sa inyo, investing, bisan wala ako kwaon sa inyo, dapat amuhon nyo man na sa inyo utod. That you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. Saying, you are my friends if you do what I command you. No? Dapat magpalangga kita, parihos man sa pagpalangga ni Boaz, parihos sa pagpalangga ni Jesus. Kaya kung hindi ka mo friends ni Jesus. Insulit niya ini sa John chapter 13, verses 34 to 35, siling niya, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also are to love one another, because by this all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. You know, expect si Jesus Christ ngang aton pag-spread sa wings. Dapat level up. And imagine, wala mga utod, kung we love the Boaz way by denying ourselves and taking up the cross, minister to one another, and go and make disciples of all nations. Pero siguro utod, kabalo ka mga nga do hindi pa kita sina kahimo. Singi Paul, do permi ko naman yung nasulit, pero nevertheless, this is a good reminder. Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. I appeal to you therefore, brothers, because of the mercies of God, because of our kinsman redeemer, who redeemed us, who restored us. Bisan wala siya kuhaon sa aton. Siling niya, you must present your bodies as living sacrifice. Holy. Inablang mabaton man na. Acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world. No? Dapat ang aton mga perspective hindi dutanon. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that by testing you may discern what the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Tuod mga ginutod, imagine kung tanan-tanan lang kita would start to spread our wings. Maybe like Naomi, no? Spread love. Ha? Hindi magsinuplada, hindi magsinuplado. No? Invest. Or like Ruth. Like Ruth. Upod-upod. Unong. Or like Boaz. Invest our best. Invest our all without expecting something in return. Kay gapatigil ako, in due season, you will reap a harvest. Mga utod, are you spreading your wings? Tandaan natin ini, giving our all is the greatest love of all. It's giving our all to God and giving our all to others for the glory of God. Giving our all is the greatest love of all. Will you? Ma-pray kita. Father God, kabay patani, nga magakabuhi kami, magapalangga kami, magaspread ang amon wings. Just like Naomi, kagmag-grow parios kay Ruth, kagmag-grow pagid, parios kay Boaz, just like the Lord Jesus Christ. Because this gives you the glory that you truly deserve. Now may the love of our God the Father, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen.
There with his hand. God. His perfect salvation, His one.